Climate Justice Project was about looking at water resources in Chikwawa. We're looking at the long-term impacts of climate resilience, climate change, and importantly, the groundwater resources here. 90% of the rural population here in Chikwawa, in fact, 90% of the population, rural population in Malawi, are dependent upon groundwater resources. We therefore have to make sure we're protecting these water resources. This borehole was installed by a UK charity in 1993. It lasted less than 10 years. Because they did not look at the hydrogeology, what we now have is this community walking down to this unprotected water supply over here to my right. Here we have open water, no protection, and the potential for communal diseases, waterborne diseases, and other impacts here in this community. This highlights the need to raise the capacity of hydrogeology here in Malawi, to make sure that we look to the past on what we've actually put in infrastructure and learn from those mistakes and make sure we don't repeat them as we're moving into the next decade of the Sustainable Development Goals. This is one of the first boreholes that our project, our CGF project in Scotland, actually implemented here in Malawi. One of the key changes that you'll see from this borehole to other boreholes in the area is the way in which we studied and evaluated whether or not salty water could get into this borehole. There may be other differences associated with the layout or how the water drains away, but the most important thing is not this infrastructure you see here, but the 50 meters of hole that actually goes down into the groundwater system and down into the sediments here. What we found is as we're drilling, we measured the salinity or the saltiness of the mud and the water that was coming back up as we're going deeper. From this, we were able to tell which zones actually had salt water as we went deeper and deeper and deeper into the ground. And what we found is the upper layers of these sediments here, the upper water that we had, because it's so hot and so dry of a climate, was evaporating every year and leaving the salts behind. And most of the salt water at this site was actually near the surface within the top 10 meters. So the innovation was to find a way of keeping that salt water from getting into the water that's pumped out of this well every day. Most of all the wells you find here in Malawi and in Africa, they drill them as fast as they can. Every time they find water, they let that water go into the well. And when that water gets into the well, it doesn't matter if it's salty or fresh, it mixes together and comes out the pump into the bucket. As we were drilling this borehole, we had a question: how do we keep that salt water from getting into the fresh water? We found the salt water at the top and the fresh water at the bottom. In Malawi, to buy bentonite and other materials that you'd find normally in North America or Europe and other places where you drill boreholes, it just isn't available. It's too expensive. So we looked around at the bricks that were here and we asked, where did they get the clay for making the bricks? And they get the clay from termite mounds. Okay, this is a termite mound that has already been mined for clay for bricks and also for some of the boreholes that we've been drilling. As you can see, termite mounds can grow to substantial heights. And essentially, there was a dead tree at this point, and the termites would use the folic acid that they produce to dissolve some of the cellulose, and then they would collect clay and actually stick the clay together with the dissolved cellulose to produce the high mounds that you actually see. This one was probably 2-3 meters tall before it was cut down and chopped up and used for making bricks using the clay, and also for some of the boreholes that we've been drilling to actually use for sealing up and producing the sanitary seals at the top of the boreholes.
So we were able to put gravel around the outside of the well casing where there was fresh water. And as soon as we knew where there was going to be salt water, we then filled up the rest of it with termite clay. That termite mound clay then effectively sealed off all the salt water from entering into the borehole. And now when we actually pump this borehole, what we're actually doing is we're getting fresh water from much deeper into the aquifer. This is why you need hydrogeological knowledge every single borehole you're drilling. And unfortunately, most of the boreholes are being drilled not only here in Malawi, but other places in SADC and in Africa don't have a day-to-day operational hydrogeologist overseeing the drilling operation. This is what we need for the future, and this is why we need hydrogeologists to come and evaluate all the pumps that have been put in the past. So when we look at the learning that we've come from on the Climate Justice Project, it's not just about knowledge in groundwater. It's not just about trying to understand water resources on the big scale or from a political point of view. It's actually trying to make sure that the next generation, the Sustainable Development Goals generation of people, are actually putting in water resources in a way that people are no longer going to be dependent upon water supplies like this.